A fine day for baseball north of the border in Toronto. The Mariners and the Blue Jays are next. We are in downtown Toronto at Rogers Centre, getting you set for this edition of Baseball on the Show. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the Seattle Mariners and the Toronto Blue Jays. With that, we welcome you inside the broadcast booth. Matt Vasgersian here with you. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, ought to be a decent pitching matchup here this afternoon.
Yeah, and as you look at the numbers for each of these starters, I think one of the big things to watch for is how many innings each of these guys can give their manager. You know, at this point in the season, both of these bullpens could use a break. So each of these managers are going to be hoping to squeeze 6, 7, maybe even 8 innings out of these guys if possible.
All right, Steve, EK will join us in a moment, but before he does, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Seattle Mariners, as they'll line themselves up like this here this afternoon. They'll have their hands full here for sure as they try and tackle the knuckleball specialist, R.A. Dickey. Defensively, the Blue Jays take the field like so. Nori Aoki heads for the box, ready to lead this one off today.
Left fielder, Nori Aoki.
And we are underway this afternoon as the first pitch is over for a called strike one.
First pitch, 107.
I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Out in front a bit as this is pulled down the line to first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there's your first out of the ballgame. Seth Smith stands in for the first time. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Here's the 0-1 now to Smith. And this is fouled back and out of play. One out, nobody on. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. Over to smoke at first, and there are two away.
Oh, pretty flashy with the leather right there. This is all the way over on the second base side of the bag. And if he decides to leave this one for the second baseman, forget about it. It's a base hit.
Cano waits on the first pitch. Ball one. Two out, nobody on. That one's a called strike. Back even at one. And now a pitch on the way. Now a swing, and oh boy, ground balls have ruled the inning. A third straight right here. Throw on to smoke at first, and the side is retired. Mariners are down in order. And now the Blue Jays will get their initial shot. No score. Starting lineup for the Blue Jays here looks like this. They'll tee it up against a surprise third-place finisher in the 2013 AL Cy Young Award balloting, the Japanese-born right-hander Hisashi Iwakuma. Mariners defensively would look like this behind him. Ezekiel Carrera comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Right fielder, Ezekiel Carrera.
And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. EK, you look at the M's entering play here this afternoon. They'll look to make it three straight here as they come in on the heels of two straight wins.
Yeah, they still find themselves stuck in third place in the division, but this is an important stretch for these guys, and if they can string a few victories together, they've got a chance to get back into it.
3-0 now.
You don't want to lose the leadoff hitter here. Not when you've got this guy on deck.
And a good comeback there. It's 3-1. Now the pitch. Now he turns on a fastball here and sends it to deep right field. There to take it is Smith, and that's out number one.
And sometimes when you're just getting rolling here in a ball game, you've got a three ball count. Hey, go ahead and lay one in there. Make him prove to you that he can beat you. This winds up a pretty routine fly ball.
Josh Donaldson comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
That's what you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone and is probably going to finish out of the zone, so that's a good job just to lay off.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Lynn there to take this one, and there are two gone now.
Having third,
Edwin Encarnacion gets his first cuts now. The bases are empty, and there are two away here in the opening frame. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Swing and a liner. And that's a base hit.
First base runner of the ball game now for either team comes with two outs here in the home front. Now, with the cleanup guy due next, things all of a sudden could get a bit interesting.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. From the stretch. Now a swing and a ground ball back up the middle. And he'll just step on second for the force, and that'll do it for this half inning. We've played an inning. No score here on the show. Nelson Cruz makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
Nelson Cruz.
Looked inside, but that's ruled a strike, nothing in one.
Whether you like it or not, now that you've seen what the strike zone's going to be like, you're going to have to make an adjustment.
I think I'd take that one, too. It's 0-2 now.
I think generous is the word here. That looked like it was 6 inches off the plate.
Two strike pitch is chopped foul at the plate, and we'll do it again.
It's all yours.
Here's Donaldson down at third. Hit hard on the ground is short. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Third baseman, Kyle Seager.
Kyle Seager will get his first cuts here. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And he'll just watch this thing to try and get an idea. It's 0-1. No score here as we play inning number two. Boy, right down the middle for strike two.
He's found a pretty nice rhythm out here early on.
Out in front as he yanks this down the line at first. On to first with it is Smoke as he'll make the unassisted put out.
Now these infielders have been busy early on, and that's another ground ball out for him. Probably not going to be the last one we see either.
Adam Lind will dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. And a high strike there, 0-1. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. But that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Mariners. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Troy Tulowitzki will stand in now, and as you can see, he enters play with 16 home runs on the season so far. Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one. A swing and a ground ball, but a foul ball, 1-1. Fastball called strike, 1-2. Tom Tulowitzki comes up empty there as he swings and misses for the first out. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Spectators, foul. Sinker, and that's ruled strike two. Bottom of the second here with no score. and a fastball blew it right by him, and they're two down.
Yeah, and on this pitch right here, you got to make up your mind just a little more quickly up there. This is a ball that you got to think about maybe taking to left field, but instead, his swing is just a little bit late. He pulls off a little bit, and now he's going to go sit down.
Close with the fastball to begin the at bat. It's ball one. Checks his swing, but this pitch is right there for strike one. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground is short. And the throw just does beat him at the bag, so the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. We'll move to the third with no score. Leonis Martin will stand in now to lead things off. 7, 8, and 9 here to start the third inning.
And maybe one of these guys can break this string of 6 straight retired to start the ball game.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. Now a swing and a high fly ball, and this one has some carry on it to deep right field. One away here to begin the third.
Batting eight, the catcher number 33, Chris Iannetta.
One gone now in the Mariners' third inning. And standing in now, the catcher, Chris Iannetta. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. Knee high, he barehands it. Over to smoke at first, and there are two away.
Shortstop, Sean O'Malley.
Sean O'Malley will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. Pilar is there, and they go down in a hurry here as his side is quickly retired. Mariners are down on 4 pitches. Home half of the third. Devin Travis digs into the box in the bottom of inning number 3.
Second baseman, Devin Travis.
Low for ball one.
One ball, no strike.
And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
And he's showing some real life with that fastball. That's a great spot on 1-0 pitch.
Now the pitch. Called strike, and he's behind 1-2.
Well, nothing fancy. 3 fastballs so far in this at-bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out.
All right, now we're going to take a look at the location of the last 2 pitches on show track. The 1-1 pitch is right at the knees. That's perfect. And then he gets them to go just a little bit lower on the 1-2, and he swings right over the top of it.
And and this is fouled at the plate. Ball one. Bottom of inning number three, nothing, nothing our score. Fouled toward the third base dugout, but this will get back into the seats out of play. One-two pitch here is a routine grounder to third. Throw gets him, two down.
One out away now from three full scoreless innings, and both pitchers are working both inside, outside, up and down. Looking solid here to start this ballgame.
Ezekiel Carrera is at the plate as he looks at ball one. Not close. It's 2-0. Now a pitch swung on and hit to the left side, but this is going to find the seats, a foul ball. Pitch on the way. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
And, oh, that should have been ball four there, but it's a called strike, and that runs things full at 3-2.
Wow, he is spotting that fastball on a dime here early on.
Hit hard, but foul toward first, so he'll come back and line it up again. Close, but it's ball four, according to Woody Keller.
You can't fault the pitch selection or the location there. It's well placed, maybe just a hair off the outside corner. But 3-2, that's where you want to be.
Hit hard to the right, but foul. This is high, a ball and a strike. A runner on first with two away. Well struck, but foul over by the coaching box. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Nori Aoki will stand in to begin their half of the fourth with his guys still looking for their first hit of the ballgame.
And still looking for their first base runner, too. Nine up, nine down.
Here it comes. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one.
Let's go,
guys. 1-0 now is swung on and chopped over to first. On to first with it is Smoke as he'll make the unassisted put out. So with that, let's call on the guys in the graphics department to put up the pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And these graphics can sometimes be a little misleading when you've got a knuckleballer on the mound, but here you go regardless. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground to the left side. On to first, and that is two quick outs to start the fourth. Second baseman Robinson Cano digs in with his team still looking at a zero in the hit column. Cano waits on the first pitch. Here's a swing and a ground ball. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Now here's the pitch. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. the pitch. Swing, high drive, deep down the left field line. This ball is slicing, and he will get there as he had to cover a lot of ground to make that play, and that ends the inning. Edwin Encarnacion is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. Here's the pitch. He'll start him with a sinker here, but that sinks a bit too much that time. It's 1-0.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
Way out in front as this is yanked foul into the seats in left. A slider that time that runs away. It's 3-1 now.
Oh, I think you'd be real happy with a leadoff walk. Something just to get things started against this guy.
Goes down and gets it as this is bounced to short. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
The batter, left fielder.
So one away in the inning now for Michael Saunders. Now here's the pitch. And that's in there for strike one. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Chased a low ball there, and he's quickly down in the count 0-2. And a breaking ball runs in and gets him, and I doubt there was any intent behind that.
Well, I know that instantly everyone's going to start pointing fingers out there, but when you're facing a guy like this, as a pitcher, you have to be allowed to work inside. That'll hurt a bit, but it's just part of the game you have to live with.
Iwakuma a look to first, and a dive, but he's back. And again a throw, and he'll get back in safely. Troy Tulowitzki is the batter now as he looks at a ball of 1-0. Comes set, now the pitch. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd, foul. That's on the corner to put him behind now. 1-2. No runs, just one hit, and no errors in the game for Toronto. On the ground is short. This could be two. Cano for one. On to Lind. It's a double play, and the inning is over. Nelson Cruz heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Nelson Cruz.
Now the pitch. In there for strike one. There's his total now, just into his fifth inning of work. Nothing too out of the ordinary there.
No, the pitch count's the least of his worries. If his guys don't get him any runs, I don't think it'll matter all that much.
Now the pitch. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Hit high in the air down the right field line. And the leadoff man gone now to start the fifth.
I think we expected to see a well-pitched game coming in, and we got one. Starting to look like the team who scores first might be the one who wins.
Now here it comes. Kyle Seager is in for the second time here as he looks at one outside. It's 1-0. Pitch on the way. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. Now here's the pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. Throw on the first, gets him from shallow right, and there's out number two.
Now batting, first baseman,
Adam Lind stands in. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out. Right there for strike one.
Well on his way to another good inning right here, and you see the pitch count. It's not even close to being a factor just yet.
And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground to the left side.
And if you walk up to him after this game and ask him how he hit that pitch, he's just going to shrug his shoulders and say, I don't know. That's as tough a location as there is, but he gets good wood on it, and he picks himself up a base hit.
And a ball popped foul to the right side, out of play. Knuckleball, 1-1.
Well, you know, things have gone his way more often than not so far this afternoon, but he certainly didn't get any help on that one.
Lined hard to center field. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Yeah, sometimes after two outs, you can let your guard down out there on the mound. But all of a sudden, back-to-back hits have given him a bit of a wake-up call here.
He's set. Now the pitch. Chris Iannetta is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. Now a swing and a ball chopped foul right at home plate. Comes set. Now the pitch. Here's a ball swung on and lofted in the air out toward right center. Pereira is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. A golden. Justin Smoke comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so we should be fine for the time being.
Now a sinker's low off the outside corner, two balls and a strike. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. Got him swinging on the split-fingered pitch, and that's out number one. Kevin Pillar stands in. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out. Pitch is in the air out toward right field. Under it is Smith as he takes it for out number two.
I think that's a situation where he just wasn't ready for the fastball, and it got on him too quickly and just hits a lazy fly ball to right.
Here's the pitch. Devin Travis stands in as he looks at a called strike. The pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. And they'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. Ball. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on 2-2, I don't think you fool around anymore.
And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Blue Jays go down in order. Sixth inning coming up, still zip, zip. Sean O'Malley makes his way to the box to lead us off in the sixth inning.
Sean O'Malley.
Here it comes. Swung on and grounded foul. In the air, down the left field line and deep. And he will run this one down, moving to his right, and that's the first out of the inning.
Another guy retired there. You see his pitching line to this point. It's phenomenal. Just two hits, both of them are singles. And he's hardly even been in trouble. Thorough domination so far.
And now for the second batter in a row. This is in the air, out to left field. And quickly, two are gone now here in the visitor's half of the sixth.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit, and it's an easy play out there in left field.
Seth Smith stands in as he looks at ball one here. And the pitch. 2-0 now. Hit high but foul, as that'll get in amongst the fans. No runs, two hits, and no errors in the game for the Mariners to this point. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. And now the knuckleball in there, strike three called, and the side is retired. Josh Tolley will get us going for the Jays here as they start their half of the sixth.
Catcher, Josh Tolley.
Grounded foul. Now the pitch. And this is reached for and fouled away off to the left as the count moves to 0-2 now. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. Under it here is Seager to make the play. One gone.
Yeah, a good pitch there as he gets the pop out on the fastball as we take a look at his pitch breakdown so far.
Ezekiel Carrera stands in, reached on a walk in his last trip. Fastball off the plate away for ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. That missed. Close. It's ball two.
Sometimes all it takes is just one call to go against you, like that one right there. And then you get yourself out of your own rhythm. You got to be able to put that behind you and move on.
Come on, we're good, let's go.
That one's in there, 3-1. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
And when he's missing, he's not missing by much. That one might have been just a hair low, but as a hitter on 3-1, you have the luxury of making a pitcher bring something up.
From the belt, the pitch. Josh Donaldson comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one.
Oh, that's a good fastball right there, and you had to figure that he was looking for that sinker.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Runner at first here, one man out.
Move them up!
And there's ball two now. Inside with the sinker, and that'll keep him honest at the plate. I'll tell you, he's already hit one guy, and he is not afraid to work inside.
No, and as much as I hate to say it, pitchers have just as much right to the inside part of the plate as you do.
And this is swung on and sent on the ground to first. There's one. Back to the pitcher covering. It's a double play, and the inning is over. So another good inning for him on the mound. Six shutout innings now. Robinson Cano will stand in here to start the seventh. EK, it's been a pitching and defense afternoon all throughout.
Yeah, neither starter looking like he's ready to blink. Neither one of them looking all that tired just yet.
And now the Blue Jays get a left-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. And he misses again to Cano. It's 2-0 now.
Two really close pitches to kick off this at-bat. Normally, this guy would be all over him, but he's shown some discipline here with two good takes.
Outside, 3-0 now.
And a 3-0 count here to start the seventh has got to be a red flag.
Ball four. And he lays off. Ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Yeah, nothing on the scoreboard yet, so maybe this can be a start as he's on base to lead off the inning.
Nelson Cruz will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. Pause, now the pitch. Now a knuckleball, and it's looked at for strike one.
And that has been the comfort zone so far in this outing. He's just lived on that outside corner, and it's paid big dividends for him.
Swing and a liner. Foul. He's ready now. The pitch. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. And they keep rolling here. Their runners at the corners with still nobody out. Kyle Seager will step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, and it's been a long time coming. They haven't done anything with their opportunities so far. Maybe this will be the time that they finally crack the scoreboard.
He's ready. Now the pitch. And that misses for ball one.
Now, with two on and nobody out, it's looking like this scoreless string could be in some jeopardy.
Here's a check swing and a foul ball. But a foul ball, 1-1. Runners are at first and third with none out. Now here's a ball hit in the air to straightaway right field. This ball's got plenty of carry to it, and it is out of here. So it's a three-run shot to straightaway right field. Number 18 for him on the campaign, and the M's have taken a 3-0 lead.
Boy, and for how well he's pitched so far, it's hard to believe that he could stand to be the losing pitcher, but that's the scenario he faces now as he serves up the lead on this home run.
Here comes a Toronto skipper out toward the pitcher's mound, and that will mean the end of the knuckleball here, as that's going to be it for R.A. Dickey. So with a lefty waiting, they'll go to a lefty of their own out of the bullpen here. Standing in now, Adam Lind. As this is popped foul behind the plate, it's strike one. And And this is swung on and missed by Lind as he falls behind, nothing and two now.
Yeah, it's so hard to stay back against a guy like this. Unless you guess right, that thing's just so slow that it's almost impossible to keep from getting out on your front foot.
Now here's the pitch. And he lifts this one the other way out to left center field. Saunders is under this one. One gone.
Center fielder number 12,
Leonis Martin will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. Now here's the pitch. The fastball here as you'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. They'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. And a change up here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Boy, he just threw that fastball by him. Now the pitch. Now a ball bounced towards the second baseman. Barehanded at his knees. Over the smoke at first, and there are two away.
The catcher number 33,
Chris Iannetta will stand in. He flew out his last time up. And now a pitch on the way. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. One and one as this one's in on the hands.
One ball, one strike.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
One strike.
And it misses. 3-1 now. Three runs already home here. Ball four. Sean O'Malley will stand in again. He's flown out in each of his first two plate appearances thus far. He waits. Now the pitch. There's a first pitch curveball trying to come back to the outside corner. Didn't get it that time. It's ball one.
And this is a guy that needs to throw that curveball for strikes.
Yeah, when he doesn't have command on it, that's when he has to lean on his fastball. And sometimes that'll get him in trouble.
Two out with the man at first. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. From the stretch to two balls and two strikes now. Full count now, 3-2.
And now the benefit of you working the count to 3-2 is that that runner gets a head start from first with two away.
He's set. Now the pitch. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. But the Mariners pick up three in the inning on this three-run home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's now 3-0 Seattle. Edwin Encarnacion will dig in here. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. And down in the Mariner bullpen, it looks like a right-hander's up to throw. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident, though. A bloop and a blast could still turn this game on its ear.
This is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. He's able to take the ball the other way here. High and deep to right center. And that's in there. Base hit. The relay. The tag. And he is called out trying for two. Bad decision.
This is going to turn into one of those no harm, no foul situations out there on the mound. He serves out the base hit here, but that guy's thinking two all the way, and it doesn't work out for him.
Michael Saunders is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1. You have to say they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
There to take it is Aoki, and there are two away now. Troy Tulowitzki will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. Here's the pitch. And he'll start in with a fastball that misses down and away for a ball, 1-0. Mm, 2-0.
Two times here they've gone away, both pretty easy takes. And as a hitter, now I'm thinking it might be time they try to bust something inside.
And Tulowitzki lifts this ball down the left field line, but it'll wind up hooking foul back up into the seats. Oh, textbook slider there, and he's back at even, 2-2.
He's closing in on putting up yet another zero.
And this is drifting foul back into the stands.
MVP.
Ready with another 2-2. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
It looked like he tried to elevate the fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Foul tip held on to behind the plate. Nice work there to get the punch out, and the inning is over. Franklin Morales is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. Nori Aoki will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0-for-3 thus far. And some action now in the Toronto bullpen as a right-hander starts to get loose. And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike. Now a swing and a fly ball hit fairly well out to deep center field. And he reaches up to track this one down for the first out, and he had to go a long way to get to that ball. It's been a low-scoring affair. 3-0 our score as we show you the numbers for our two starters to this point in the contest. Seth Smith is at the plate as he watches ball one. One out, nobody on. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. On the first with it is Smoke as he'll make the unassisted put out. couple of good pitching performances by both clubs here. 3-0 our score as you get a look there at the inning-by-inning recap through the first seven and change. Cano waits on the first pitch. Robinson Cano is at the plate now, and he takes a cold strike.
Yeah, a little surprising he didn't offer at that one. That was a dangerous spot for a good fastball hitter.
Down and away, ball one. There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning.
That's a pitch that you got to stay on top of, or else it'll take off on you just like that one did.
Here's a ball hit foul down the third baseline, so they'll try it again. Bases are empty here with two men out. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2. What's the call here?
I still don't think I'd throw him a strike. There's a good chance that he's going to be chasing something, expand the zone, so you make him show you that he can hold back.
Hey, you know what? That's all right. He gave him a pretty good battle up there, and he never gave in to him. A walk you can work around. A home run, you can't.
Nelson Cruz will dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk. Come set, now the pitch. Oh, and a good live fastball there for Morales. Nothing in one. And he reaches out for one and may have chased it as this is skied into the air to straightaway center. Pilar will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Justin Smoak stands into the box. He's 0-2 so far in this one.
Justin Smoak.
And a high strike there, 0-1. And a splitter here, but he had a bit too much on it as this bounces up to the plate. Down low, two balls and a strike.
A much better approach here at the plate so far. But he's not working from behind in the count like he has his first few at-bats.
And, ooh, that strike zone's getting a little inconsistent now. It's 2-2. And he struck him out, and there's the hat trick, as that's his third strikeout of the ball game. Kevin Pillar will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Breaking ball that's cut on and missed for the first strike. Swing and a bouncing ball toward the hole. Throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close. Devin Travis will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
Curveball just misses, apparently, 1-0. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now. And the pitch. Now a ball hit high down the left field line, but back in amongst the spectators, foul. The pitch. Splitter called strike two, and I don't think he liked it. And now a sharply hit ball toward the right side as this gets foul past the coaching box. Now the pitch. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Too high, ball three.
Such a good at-bat right here. When you can grind out 7-8 pitches against a guy that's running short on gas, that can be huge.
Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. Fouled off into the seats behind first. And now this will be the 10th pitch of the at-bat. Swing and a ball hit on the ground, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. A payoff pitch one more time. And this one misses inside, a ball he walked in, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Guys, that's just an amazing at-bat right there. All that guy on the mound wants to do is find that one put-away pitch and get him back in the dugout, but try as he might, he never could find it. And he winds up not only losing this guy, but taking up a big chunk of his stamina to do it.
Josh Tolley is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. Comes set, now the pitch. And this is heading out toward left field, but this is going to get fouled up into the crowd. Swing and a bouncing ball to third. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. One left for Toronto. They trail it here 3-0. Kyle Seager will stand in again as we flash you back to earlier. He's accounted for their only runs of the ball game on one swing of the bat, as this was the swing right here. Pitch on the way. Hit hard but fouled off to the left, and that'll keep you honest as a third base coach. Now here's the pitch. Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. Here it comes. And they'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Yeah, with the bases empty, that's the right spot for that 0-2 pitch. Make him see if he'll chase that slider.
This is lifted the other way out to left center. And the leadoff man retired here to kick off the ninth. Adam Lind will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Here's the pitch. And that misses ball one.
Yeah, looked like he hit the target. That's a tough pitch to lay off, but he made it pan out.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
And this is all about handling a guy like this with kid gloves. You know, walk him if you have to, but don't let him be the one to beat you.
And this is going to be a foul ball. Bases are empty, one man out. And he lays off again, ball three.
3-1.
That's in there, and it'll run the count to full, 3-2. And now for the second batter in a row, this is in the air out to left field. And Saunders will handle this one for out number two. Leonis Martin will step in, a ground out victim his last time. And a ball, 1-0. And he falls behind now, 2-0.
Yeah, a little unlucky here to be behind 2-0. Those first couple of pitches haven't missed by a whole lot.
fouled straight back. And the pitch. There's the cold strike he was looking for. 2-2 now. Two out, nobody on. He'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate with the fastball as he backs him off a bit. The pitch. And he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. Mariners are down in order, but they're on top by a count of 3-0. Ezekiel Carrera stands in, reached on a walk in his last trip. Off the plate and away there, one ball, no strikes. Well, a good swing there as this is deep down the line and right, but this is going to wind up out of play. Now here it comes. Swing and a liner, but this is a foul ball. Ball hit out towards Cano at second. A quick out number one. Josh Donaldson will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. Now here's the pitch. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
Down and away, ball one.
Playing the leg.
Now the pitch. And that misses, 2-1. One out, nobody on. This is sent on the ground now for the first baseman, Lynn. And he'll take this on to first, and they're down to their final out, two away. Edwin Encarnacion will stand in now as their last shot here with two away in the ninth.
Yeah, just one final hurdle here before he finishes off the shutout.
Here's the pitch. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Look out. 2-0 now.
These have both been easy takes so far. Neither one of these pitches really approaching the strike zone.
And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. And that's through for a base hit.
And they're able to keep the inning alive as you check out the numbers on his performance so far. That's just the third hit he's allowed to this point. He's been pretty much in control the whole way.
Pause, now the pitch. Michael Saunders is in with two away as he takes a ball, 1-0.
And now you got to regroup after the two-out single. You're in a dangerous spot in the lineup, so the inning's not over yet. Not by a long shot.
Not quite reaching 90 with the fastball, but it's 1-1 now. Here's a swing and a ground ball for Seager down at third. Throw on to second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Well, we've talked about it all throughout this game. He was completely in charge, essentially, from pitch one. And now he finishes off a masterful performance here, getting the complete game shutout.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. And guys, you can't win if you can't score, so there's probably not a whole lot of debate about who'll take home Topps Player of the Game honors in this one.
Yeah, definitely no debate as far as I'm concerned. He was really in complete control the whole way through. Only really got into trouble a few times, and he winds up with a complete game shutout.
So that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. Thanks to Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and the rest of our crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. To find out more, head on over to theshownation.com. The Mariners win it.